In Revelation chapter 1, John has this amazing vision of the risen, glorified Christ. It's awesome. Welcome to Pastor Brad Rocks, man. I am Pastor Brad, and I love to rock. I love to create classic, hard rock, metal-style music that glorifies and honors God. And as a pastor, I love to teach the Word of God in a way that will build you up. I like to say, rocks you up in your faith. If it sounds like that would be a blessing to you, man, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the like and share button and help me get the word out. Really appreciate that. In video number one, we introduced the mean meant rule, a super important rule that says the scripture can never mean something it never meant. We also talked about the nature and the key traits of apocalyptic literature and prophecy. If you missed that, I'll put the link to that video in the description as well. Go check that out. Now we're going to get into this vision that John had of the risen, glorified Jesus. But just before we do, let's talk about a couple really cool things that John says in these verses leading up to this vision. In verse 3, John says this: "Blessed is the one who reads aloud the words of this prophecy, and blessed are those who hear it and take to heart what is written in it, because the time is near." This book was intended to be read from start to finish out loud. In the first century, the majority of Christians couldn't read. And so when a letter came to a church from an apostle, they would all gather together, and someone who could read well would stand up, and they would read aloud the letter from the beginning to the end. And as John is writing Revelation, he's not thinking, oh, they're going to break this word down and this phrase down. John wasn't thinking, hey, man, they're going to pick this book apart, every word, every line, every comma. No, John intended this letter to be read from start to finish, and for all these visions and symbols and numbers and all these thoughts to just sweep over you and make impressions on your heart. And it's those impressions that really convey the message of the book. Download a Bible app, get the audio version, click play, listen to the book of Revelation, and here's the message you're going to get. The world is a broken, sinful, messed up place. It is utterly rebellious against God. There are powers and forces that be that hate the church. In this world, just like Jesus said, you will have trouble. But take heart, because our Lord has overcome the world. God is absolutely sovereign over all history. Jesus is risen. He is Lord of Lords, King of Kings. Fix your eyes on Him. Yes, there will be tough times, but guess what? We win. So stay faithful, because great is the reward of those who keep their eyes fixed on Jesus. Now, you might word it a little bit differently, but that's the gist of it. Hey man, if you're getting value from this video, remember to click the like button and share this with a friend. So let's talk about this vision that John has of Jesus. I'm practicing what I'm preaching here. I just went back and I listened to this section of the book, and I just wrote down the impressions, the thoughts that just hit me as I listened to it. John says, "I was in the spirit and he heard this voice that sounded like a trumpet. So he turned to see who the voice came from, and he saw this unbelievable, mind-blowing vision of the resurrected, glorified Jesus. And Jesus told him, write this down and send this to the churches." Here's what we get from this vision. Jesus is awesome. He is risen forever. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the ruler over all creation, Lord over all lords, King over all kings. He is absolutely 100% holy and righteous, and we are called to revere Him and serve Him faithfully to the end, even unto death. And we must always remember that our current circumstances are not the end of the story. That day is coming, and for all who are faithful to the Lord Jesus, that is going to be a glorious day. Now, you can go back and break down all of the different aspects of this vision, and it's awesome. But it's the impression that we want to take away from it, right? It's how it moves us. It's how it inspires us. That's the point. A lot of people who left that meeting the first night that Revelation was written to them, they might have been able to quote little bits and pieces of the letter, but they all walked away with this impression. Dude, life is hard, but God is good. He is with us, and He's coming back, and we win. Jesus really is risen. He really is Lord of all. Hang tough. Now that we understand what it meant to the first century audience, can you not already begin to see some application for us today? Do we not still live in a broken world that is rebellious to God? As I record this, there are Christians probably being executed right now in Afghanistan. Horrible. And that's one of the things we're going to see. This letter has had a powerful message to groups of Christians in almost every generation at some place around the globe in every decade of history. There have always been expressions of cruelty and evil that have tried to destroy the church. And this letter has always been there to say, hang tough. Jesus is risen. God is with you. He is sovereign. He's always been sovereign. He is sovereign. And He is moving all of this toward His designed end. You remain faithful. That's his message to you and me today, man. Whatever you're facing, God is with you. The King is with you. His Spirit is with you. His promises are true. Oh, man, we're going to continue to walk through this book. In the next video, we're going to look at these letters to these seven churches that Jesus dictated. And we're going to look at it through the lens of the mean mint rule. And it's going to bless you, man. Thanks for hanging out with me. And if you have any questions or thoughts, definitely leave them in the comments, man. I'd love to interact with you. God bless you, man. Catch you in the next video.